It is this mother of five facing two counts of contributing to the delinquency of minor. Anahita, A, is that a sufficient charge? And B, what is going to happen to her?
That's a sufficient charge. I think she's going to be convicted. She's probably going to have to serve some time and definitely, hopefully, get some counseling. I mean, she's an admitted alcoholic. She's an admitted sex addict. And I think, Dr. Drew, a lot of this, too, is her trying to be cool. It's another parent that's trying to be a friend
maybe,
to her
kids. Maybe, but if she's as sick as you say she is, she doesn't know what she's doing. And Sam, I see you with a look of incredulity on your face. What's going on?
That's a sufficient charge? What about the fact that she's performing sex acts in front of all these teenagers? She's showing her daughter pictures of her having sex with men. That's all pornographic material.
And it's allegedly
and
all these allegations.
And it's alleged,
point,
and she's out on bond for $3,000. Really? No, I think that it should have been a much stiffer
sentence. Deneen, what are you thinking?
I agree with Sam and even go a little step farther. She supposedly had sex with a 16-year-old. Now, if this had been the dad and he had awakened to having sex with a 16-year-old girl, we'd be talking about something different here.
I don't understand. I believe the age of consent is 16 in that state.
Is
that right?
That's how she avoided that.
Listen, by the way, that does not make it good or okay for the 16-year-old. Trust me on that. That is not okay. She has five children. She gave birth to the first one at the age of 19. She was a devout Mormon until she separated from her husband and eventually separated from the church. She was attempting to maintain abstinence from alcohol, but apparently when she left the church, that exploded a bit. And I've seen a lot of that. I've seen a lot of people in the Mormon church who suddenly become, I've treated a lot of that. Her estranged husband, guys, was someone who served in Iraq and also struggled with PTSD. I mean, as usual, it's not, when you start thinking about what this woman was suffering with, it starts to make more sense how this outlandish behavior could have happened, right? Anybody?
Let me ask this.
She goes to 12-step. Her AA sponsor has said that she is also a member of the sex addiction support group at her church. She has admitted to being addicted to porn and obviously other sexual behavior. So she's an addict. But one of the things that was troubling here in this case, and a lot of people on our Twitter and Facebook feeds were talking about this. It was her AA sponsor who reported this. So, Anahita, what is the obligation of a sponsor when he or she is hearing very confidential material but is aware of it potentially being harmful to others?
Right. I'm glad. I think this sponsor did the right thing, as hard as it is, because you do want to maintain that confidentiality so that the other person feels comfortable opening up and talking about things. But I think the sponsor did the absolute right thing here. And you guys, these charges are not minor charges. She is going to be punished, as she should. But what I'm saying is she clearly needs to get counseling, parenting classes. She has a lot of issues, Dr. Drew. And I bet you, if we look back into her history, she probably grew up in a lot of trauma in her life.
Possibly. That's probably true. I mean, that's sort of the way it goes, as you know well. Yeah, cycle of abuse, cycle of trauma.
Right.
But it's strange in this case, though, how this woman seemed to have been well put together and then suddenly exploded with trouble. Sam, I don't know if you have any insight into that, but I think that this is mostly about the addiction spiraling out of control. And I must tell you, I'm conflicted about what the sponsor did. I mean, I want people to feel as though they can say anything to their sponsor. I need them to be able to do that. And especially, but if they're going to harm somebody else, the sponsor does have an obligation to speak up about it.
I think the sponsor did the right thing. And let's remember that this woman was only like 4 days sober, Dr. Drew. So it's not like that she had this long amount of sobriety and she had built this relationship with the sponsor. I think the sponsor absolutely did the right thing. And I'm concerned about this daughter now, because the apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
All these kids need help.
Justifying
all the kids who are involved in this are going to need a lot of help.
And